This video is going to divide opinion, so to some degree you're going to just have to trust me, and you'll also have to put up with my croaky throat, but that doesn't stop me from ploughing on. Let's watch the clip. So this clip is from the perspective of a cyclist, and we are watching this pedestrian here who's just about to cross the road. Now, the lights for the pedestrian are on red, so they should have stopped. However, this vehicle comes around and beeps the horn. Now, the debate is as to whether or not that driver should have stopped and who is at fault. Now, of course, the pedestrian should have stopped, because at a light-controlled crossing, pedestrians should only cross when it is green for them to do so, and they should stop if the lights for the pedestrian are on red. But this is a should rule, and not a must or must not rule. And so the other rules in terms of priority and hierarchy on the road and who poses the most danger to each other, it should, I hope, be relatively obvious that the vehicle is going to pose more danger to the pedestrian than the pedestrian to it. Therefore, the driver should have stopped. The driver obviously saw the pedestrian because had time to sound the horn, which I'll come back to in a moment, but kept driving nonetheless. And the pedestrian kept walking, nonetheless. So there is blame on both sides here. I'm not squarely blaming the driver, and I'm not letting the pedestrian off the hook. Should the driver have actually impacted the pedestrian and caused any kind of injury, there would be some blame on both sides. As for the pedestrian, it would be a contributory negligence on the part of the pedestrian because they should not have been crossing the road. A little bit of volenti non fit injuria comes into this. In other words, if you voluntarily enter some kind of risk, you cannot ordinarily then claim for injury that arises. If it can be shown that this pedestrian was quite aware that the traffic lights were on red to them, then they should not have crossed. But that doesn't absolve the driver of full responsibility, because the court will see it that the driver should have stopped. The driver had the time to sound the horn, which, as I said, I'll come back to in a moment. But because of that, instead of sounding the horn, the driver could have availed themselves of that opportunity to slow down and or stop the car to avoid any danger whatsoever. Coming back to the sounding of the horn, this is covered in Rule 112 of the Highway Code. Many people in the Twitter thread will be saying that the car must not blast the horn. Now, it's true to say that the car must not be blasting the horn aggressively, which this is on that very edge, if not cross the threshold of being aggressive. Maybe you'll let me know what you think in the comments. This will be on that cusp of where the court finds that that was aggressive. But that, of course, is not the biggest issue in this video. Rule 112 provides that with the horn, you should only use the vehicle's horn when you are moving, and you need to warn other road users of your presence. But it also says never sound your horn aggressively, and you must not use your horn when stationary, built-up areas, and so on and so forth. So the bottom line, really, about that is that the driver was not entirely wrong for sounding the horn, because the driver was alerting the pedestrian to the vehicle's presence, which was correct. Was it aggressive? Well, that is a somewhat objective decision to make. In my view, it was just on that edge of being aggressive, but not so aggressive that it should really be the biggest problem in this video. The biggest problem in this video, of course, is should the driver have stopped? And in my view, absolutely yes, because there was an inherent risk and a continuing risk that the vehicle was going to hit the pedestrian. If so, the vehicle is going to cause significantly more damage to the pedestrian than the pedestrian would cause to it. The pedestrian was not in the right. The pedestrian should have stopped, but also the vehicle, as I said, in the hierarchy is going to cause more damage to the pedestrian, and therefore the vehicle, in my view, was the most at fault. But I understand why this will cause debate and divide opinions. But at the end of the day, we need to come back to a little bit of common sense in that the vehicle is going to seriously hurt the pedestrian if there's any impact. I've been hit by a car before now, and it's not pleasant, and my cousin was killed by a car. So I very much understand the risks of vehicles colliding with pedestrians. And when you think of it in that context and the amount of people that are injured or killed by vehicles, even if they're crossing the road or whatever it is they might be doing, You put this into context with a sprinkling of common sense, and I hope you will agree the vehicle should have stopped, and then nothing more would have happened. But perhaps there should be fines levied against pedestrians for putting other people, including the vehicles and their drivers, in harm's way by breaking the rules of the highway code. I, for one, would support that because, lo and behold, as a barrister, I support following the rules. Not least of which, because I'm a barrister and I have to tell you to follow the rules, but also the majority of these rules are just there to protect and to uphold the common sense rule of law for the safety of all involved. Let me know your thoughts, comments in the box below. Apologies for the croaky voice, but that doesn't stop me. I will fight on. For that alone, please like this video and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.